All's Well That Ends Well, anonymous 18th century. A friend of mine was married to a scold. To me he came, and all his troubles told. Said he, "She's like a woman raving mad." "Alas, my friend," said I, "that's very bad." "No, not so bad," said he, "for with her true, I had both house and land and money too." "That was well," said I. "No, not so well," said he, "for I and her own brother went to law with one another. I was cast, the suit was lost, and every penny went to pay the cost." "That was bad," said I. "Oh, no, not so bad," said he, "for we agreed that he the house should keep, and give to me 40 of Yorkshire sheep. All fat and fair and fine they were to be." "Well then," said I, "sure that was well for thee." "No, not so well," said he, "for when the sheep I got, they every one died of the rot." "That was bad," said I. "No, not so bad," said he, "for I had thought to scrape the fat, and keep it in an oaken vat, then into tallow, melt for winter store." "Well then," said I, "that's better than before." "'Twas not so well," said he, "for having got a clumsy fellow to scrape the fat and melt the tallow, into the melting fat the fire catches, and like brimstone matches, burnt me house to ashes." "That was bad," said I. "No, not so bad," said he, "for what is best, my scolding wife got burnt up with the rest."